understand about the nerve degeneration meridian, that is the neurological meridian to be taken place by activating the index finger. Do you know Sheng Yang, Erjian, San Jian, He Gu, Yang Si, LI1, LI2, LI3, LI4, LI5, which is located on the radial side? LI1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is radial side. But same first finger, index finger, on the other side, on the ulnar side, this meridian is called as a nerve degeneration meridian. So that's called as a, it is treatable for the entire system of the body. For example, I'll tell you, the first point of the, do you know where is LI1? Yeah, point 1 chun, proximal to the, this is the corner, is radial corner of the nail base of the index finger. Whereas in point 1 chun, proximal to the ulnar corner of the nail base of the index finger, is the first point is called as a nerve degeneration first point. So this point is good point to treat for the, especially for the spine, low back pain and all the spinal cord related, especially the lower back issues, lumbar sacral point. So this point is good point to treat for low back pain. This point also good point to treat for the low back pain. See, it looks awesome and amazing stating that this is the point, is LI1 is good point to treat for the intestine. Intestine is the reason to cause the back pain also. How many of them is agree on it? Because there is a colon get retention, stenosis or stagnation, or there is a bowel irregularities, constipation, or something connected to the diarrhea, all are leads to problem of the back pain. Back pain is not only the reason that because of the nerve compression or the disc bulge or the disc prolapse or the LDH, lower disc herniation. So anything, spondylosis, osteophytes, paraspinal muscle spasm, so all are, there is the reasons, no doubt. But without that reason, sometimes the people will get affected the back pain due to the colon related problem as well. Since if you are treating this point and this point, LI1 both the sides, do you know the beauty of the Sheng Yang, that is LU11? LU11 point is located on the radial side. If you apply LU11 on the ulnar side, that also lung 11 only, right? If you apply this, I think I have written one article this Tuesday, I think came in the Salar News, national newspaper. So in that paper I have given, the word is coming, I am just executing that. So once you give the pressure to this both the points, see how really sometimes I feel very proud and happy. Now just you give the pressure to this both the sides, that means you are activating to the Sheng Yang point, that is, no, not Sheng Yang, Shao Shang, LU11 point. So LU11 is located both the sides. Don't think it's located on one side, it is located on the both the sides. Either by mistake you applied here or there, according to the Chinese medicine, this is LU11. According to the Western medicine, this located is here. So both the sides are LU11, right? Now according to the Western medicine, this is for the low back pain. According to the Chinese medicine, this is for the low back pain and common cold and colon related problem, multiple conditions. But if you apply both, so that works for the spine, lower back. Now you understand in later future, you wanted to treat for the low back pain conditions, you just use it both the points if really they have the colon related issues as well. If they don't have the colon problem, ignore the LI1 point, then you just apply on the other side, on the ulnar side LI1 point, that always is good for the lumbar sacral pain, right? Number one. Number two, because of the lumbar sacral is connected to the autonomic, especially the parasympathetic nervous system. This works for the parasympathetic. When you come to here, so this point to be treatable for the cervical related problems, right? Where the called as a PA C, PA means 8, C means is the unity of the 8 points, right? 1 is 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, right? How pafeng? Pafeng means is the half tune proximal to the web margins. All the 4, 5 fingers is called as a pa si. Pa means 8. So pafeng, pafeng means is the 0.5 tune proximal. Some authors written 0.5 tune proximal. Some people believes that on the web margin itself, on the interdigital fold, that means this is the interdigital folds, right? Otherwise we call as a web margin also. This is called as a web margin or interdigital fold. So 0.5 tune proximal to that region also called as a is the pa si is fingers, pa feng is those points, that is the extra 38 points, right? Those points also consider as a circulation of the ankle circulation, toes circulation, palmaris circulation, and also plantar circulation. So that means on the lower extremities. So if it is affected, the numbness or the pain or tingling sensation, burning sensation, all are connected to the pa feng, pa si, you can apply. But what I mean to say, here the point is activated, 0.5 chun. That pa si point I told you, that extra point, extra 31, this is extra 38, that is. This extra 31, sometimes the numbers get changes. That's the reason I keep it, the names should be like a Chinese names, so that we never forget. Yeah, this is, some authors write that extra 1 is this, extra 2 is this, extra 3 is like this, and some authors write in the different level according to their understanding. So we don't want to keep it extra 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There is no total standard acupuncture points, but however the WHO has given 42 extra acupuncture points has been recognized international standard level. So, but however, those points are the international standard. But some authors simply they write this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So what they are teaching, their methodology, they will tell extra 1 is this, extra 2 is this, extra 3 like that. But we studied on those days, extra 1 is this, extra 2 is, I didn't remember what is that. So extra 1 is in tang, yuan, he, se, chin, something like that the points are looking. If we remember the pin in names, I think that will be, we never forget. So this is the, this passi is here only. There is no changes at all. You understand? So now this passi point is located here for the cervical. And this is, in fact, this point we called as a Lausen. Lausen also, it is extra point. I don't know the number, but it is extra point. So Lausen, L-O-U-Z-H-E-N, this Lausen point is good point, it is extra point. But extra point to treat for the two problems, keep it in your mind, according to the TCM. But according to the Western, I'll tell you. But now this Lausen point is treatable for the condition of, especially for the neck pain and shoulder pain on the opposite side. Right shoulder pain is there, right cervical pain is there. For that you just apply on the left side Lausen point, whereas in vice versa. So this is really good point to treat for the neck pain and then shoulder brachial syndromes, right? Number one. Now I come to the Western perspective. Actually I am moving somewhere, subject is different, I am going to stepping into somewhere, things are coming, you just listen, everything is informative, right? So now if you apply here according to the Western medicine, this called as a brain, this called as a central nervous system. If you wanted to activate, you are activating to the brain system. According to the TCM, you are activating to the shoulder and then cervical. That means the medulla oblongata, below the medulla, there is a connectivity of the spinal cord. Midway between the atlas and axis, there is a connectivity on the cervical region. Right. So from there it comes to the C3, C4, C5, C6, C7. After the C7, in between the each vertebrae in the foramina, that in the spinal canal, it goes the spinal cord. That is the anatomical aspect. Whereas in this point is connecting to the spinal cord. That means cervical pain. Cervical pain belongs to the C1 to C7. You understand? Neck pain is connected to the, not only neck pain is because of the one problem. I believe sometimes there is a problem between the 1 to 7. But 1, 2, it doesn't cause much. But 3, 3 to 7 vertebras causing the neck pain in normally. Right? So now this point is according to the TCM. It works for the lower portion of the brain, but according to the Western medicine, this works, this Lau's end points works for the brain, right? According to the Sujok micro standard micro system, so this thumb corresponds to the brain. But if you wanted to understand the mega level about the traditional medicine, then the all the tip of the fingers is to be considered as a brain. You understand? So that's the reason I think I have written one article. So you just activate this. I think I have given this, how to improve the memory. तो स्कूल के कॉलेज बच्चों के लिए मेमोरी बढ़ाने के लिए क्या करना है, हमने आर्टिकल लिखा था. यू जस्ट एक्टिवेट लाइक दिस. इफ़ यू एक्टिवेट दिस, यू आर एक्टिवेटिंग टू द होल सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम, बिकॉज दिस हैविंग द ग्रेट नर्व एंडिंग्स एंड दैट कम्युनिकेटिंग एंड हैविंग द एड्रेनर्जिक इफेक्ट, सो दैट इज डायरेक्टली सपोर्टिंग टू द सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम एज ए प्रॉपर स्ट्रांग सर्कुलेशन टू द ब्रेन. So because this is the terminal of the fingers. So what is the nails? Nails is the dead tissue. But before that there is active tissues to strengthen the central nervous system. So now you understand this point is Lau's end point is to treatable for the brain function. The third category is, I am talking about one meridian called as a nerve degeneration meridian. So now there is another point is amazing. So that particular point to be treatable for all the 12 cranial nerves. So that point is located midway between the first and second. Yeah, second and third. Midway between the second and third base of the metacarpal bones in the depression. So how to identify that? You just place it like this and fold your fingers and then come down. So where are you communicating is the base. So this bone is third bone, head of the metacarpal bone, second of the metacarpal bone. In the zoom, they can see my hand, fingers. Please comment.
Yes, sir.
Good, good. Yes, sir. Yes, good. So now you just see, you just come down. So where the at the base of the second and third carpal bones starts, there is the carpal bones are there, that is the wrist bones. Below the wrist bones, the carpal bones starts. This is the carpal bones. Leg bones are called as the tarsal bones, right? So now this at the base is called as a cranial nerves. If you wanted to understand in the better way, I think who completed the Sujok acupuncture, they know that where are the kidneys are located bilaterally. Where the kidneys are located, the first kidney midway between the first and second and third here, and then one more kidney is located here. But one more kidney, I'll tell you Western perspective. Here is located is the cranial nerves. How many cranial nerves? 12 cranial nerves. I think you all know. Uta, Fak, Vav. You keep it in your visualization. Uta. Tino Uta. Uta, Fak, F-A-G, Fak, Vav. V-A-H, Vav. Right?